This was a combined voyage with the United States Antarctic Program, and it was actually focusing on both humpbacks and minke whales. And the idea is to work on a place in Antarctica where both animals are feeding and have a look at how they feed differently. Went down to a place called the Gerlach Strait, which is a beautifully protected stretch of water in among the islands off the western side of the Antarctic Peninsula, and worked in the bays there. So it's really productive. It's an area where a lot of Antarctic krill moves through the whole area. Sort of size of prey patches at different depths, and we have no idea what those are. So this was actually, for minke whales, our first real insight into the differences between these two key species. So we're using a whole range of different tags that give us different information, and at the same time we have tags on, we have boats going around looking at the prey, the depth it's at, and what's in their environment. So we go from the very short-term tags, and we have to get these ones back. So you put a tag on the back of an animal, it's held on by suction cups, and it will stay on there for hours to perhaps one day, and then it will just fall off naturally. The suction cups will give up and it will float to the surface, and we retrieve it, and it measures everything. So we can tell the number of tail fluke strokes on the way down to the prey, pitch and roll and turning through the prey and everything. So we get incredibly dense information, and at the same time we measure with echo sounders from a separate boat where the krill are. And then another type that we stick on the animal that have to stay longer. So these are fired through the skin of the animal, and then they just embed in the blubber and the underlying tissue just below the blubber, and they stay on, well, we hope, for months. They just give us location, but they give us the middle to large scale movements of the whales. So where they go from those summer feeding grounds, how they move around those summer feeding grounds, and we hope they last long enough to tell us where they go for their winter breeding. We had no idea how minke whales were really going to act around the small boat. They're a much smaller whale than the type of whales we have a lot of experience in tagging, and they're much faster. So the boat driver sits alongside a group of minke whales and slowly comes in on the boat until we're just part of a school of whales, and then they're surfacing around us. And then it's a matter of me on the bow selecting a whale, and then when that animal surfaces in the right range and the right distance from the boat, shooting a tag onto the back of that whale. So it's quite tense, but it's really exciting when we successfully deploy the tags. This summer is the very first time ever that these type of tags have been put on Antarctic minke whales. In fact, any type of tag. So it's really exciting. We're going to combine the data and really bring forward brand new information about this species.